Hello guys, so in this lecture we are going to go through the decision making sums. We are going to go through four different cases for the decision making. To learn the ABC costing method, please refer to the previous live session or the videos recorded by Rohan. That will be helpful for the ABC costing. So let's get started. So in decision making, first let us go through different basics. So first of all, we need to identify the problem. Second is identifying the alternatives as possible solutions to the problem. So basically these alternatives will be given in the question itself. The different cases will be given in the questions. So you need to act accordingly. Next is eliminate alternatives that are not feasible. So in a particular case, you will be given two or three different alternatives, and on the basis of the profit earned, you need to eliminate the alternative that is not possible. That is the decision you have to make. The next is collect the relevant data associated with feasible alternatives. Now there will be some irrelevant costs that will not make any effect on the decision-making process. So you need to identify that and eliminate that. Now, these are all some of the basics that you will learn when as you go through the cases that I'm going to solve now. The main thing that you need to learn over here is that profit equals to contribution margin minus the fixed cost. Remember this formula because it is going to be used in every case. And also one more thing, you will always, when there is a limiting factor, you will always calculate the contribution margin per limiting factor and not per unit. So always consider contribution margin per limiting factor. These two things you need to keep in mind while solving each and every sum. So let's, without wasting any time, let's get started with the first case. So here is the Tanishq company that manufacture medals for winners of athletic events and other contests. And its manufacturing plan has the capacity to produce 10,000 medals each month. Okay. So first of all, here the revenue per medal is 150 rupees. The direct material cost is 2,62,500. The direct labor variable cost per batch. Now the thing over here is that, this variable cost is on a single unit of batch. Now in the question over here, it is given that company produces 50 medals per batch. So for producing 7,500 medals, it will take 75,000 rupees. The fixed manufacturing cost is 2,75,000, and the fixed marketing cost is 1,75,000. These two values doesn't change with the quantity. So the total cost will be this much. So this whole data is given for 7,500 units. Not 10,000 units, okay? So here is here the situation is given to us. Tanishq just received a special one-time order only for 2,500 medals at rupees 100 per medal. So for these 2,500 medals, the revenue will be 100 rupees. Accepting the special order would not affect the company's regular businesses. So now whenever such a statement is given that accepting the special order would not affect the company's regular businesses, in such scenario, you need to keep in mind that the fixed cost, that is in this case, the fixed manufacturing cost and the fixed marketing cost, this cost will not be levied on the new special order. So this cost will be only levied on the regular orders that they are manufacturing. We will not consider this fixed cost in the special order. That you keep in mind whenever such statement is given that the regular business is not affected or the company has sufficient capacity to produce some extra for the extra order. So in any case, if such a thing is given, don't consider the fixed cost on that new order. That applies to any case. Sotanis makes medals for his existing customer in batch sizes of 50 medals, that is 7,500 medals. So for that, 150 batches will be required because 150 into 50 equals to 7,500. But for this new special order, Tanish requires to make medals in 25 batches of 100 each. So now the here this variable cost is, this variable cost is per batch. It is not on the, it doesn't depend on the number of medals in the batch, but it is per batch. So for 150 batches, the variable cost is 75,000. So if we calculate per batch, it is 500 rupees per batch. Okay. So now, first of all, going through the first question. So now we will calculate the operating income without special order, with special order, and the differential earning that we are going to earn with the special order. So for 7,500 units, 7,500 multiplied by 150. So it will be 11,25,000. Now for this extra 10,000 units, for this extra 10,000 units, when the special order is taken, the revenue will become 13,75,000. That is 2,500 units into 100 rupees per medal. So when you add this 2,250,000 plus 11,25,000, you get 13,75,000. Now direct material. So direct material, it was given here as 2,62,500 for 7,500 medals. So similarly, we will calculate the direct material per unit, that is 2,62,500 divided by 7,500. That gives us 35 rupees per medal. So this direct material cost is same for the special order also. So 35 into the new order, that is of 2,500, it will give us 87,500 cost. So the total cost of the new order will be, the total cost of the combined order, that is special order plus the regular order, will be 3,50,000. Again, similarly, we'll calculate the direct labor per unit of medal, that is 40 rupees. So now again, we will multiply this 40 with these new 2,500 units. So the direct labor for the new special order will be 1,00,000 rupees. So the total cost for the, with the special order and the previous order, will be 4,00,000. Then calculating the direct manufacturing cost. So as I said, the direct manufacturing cost is per unit of batch. So we calculated over here, we calculated that 500 rupees is required per batch. So now for this 2,500 units, the number of batch will be, there will be the number of batch will be 100. I'm sorry. The number of batch will be, yeah. So 25 batches of 100 each. So number of batches will, batch will become 25. Yeah. So 25, the number of, I'm sorry for that pause. So the number of batches will be 25 batches. So 125 batch multiplied by 500, you get 12,500 rupees. That is the cost of direct manufacturing cost for the new special order. So now again, the fixed manufacturing cost is going to remain same. That is 2,75,000 will be levied on this. There will be no extra cost for the special order that we are manufacturing. Again, fixed marketing cost will not be applied to the new special order. So the total cost for the special order is this much, and the net income earned by the new special order is 50,000 rupees. So when this 50,000 combined with the original profit that we are earning without the special order, it comes out to be 87,500. So now the answer to this question will be, company must go ahead and take the special order because the company is increasing the operating income. Over here, there was no limiting constraint to the company given. The company had sufficient capacity for the new special order. So it was a very simple case. Now moving ahead. In the second case, suppose plant capacity were only 9,000 medal instead of 10,000 medals each month. Now the special order must either be taken in full capacity or rejected completely. Should Tanishq accept the special order? So your calculations. So in this case, the thing is that before the manufacturing capacity of company was 10,000 rupees only, 10,000 medals only. Now the manufacturing capacity is reduced to 9,000 medals only. And the special order of 2,500 units can be taken fully or has to be rejected. So if you go and reject the special order, you need to manufacture the 9,000 medals as you were manufacturing on the previous basis. So let's go ahead and do that calculation now. Now, if you go ahead with the special order, what will be the scenario when you accept the special order fully? So the usual order is, if you go ahead and take 2000 special order of 2,500 units, then you will be able to manufacture 6,500 units of the usual orders because the total capacity is 9,000 only. So the revenues for the 6,500 units, as we calculated earlier, 6,500 into price of each medal, that is 150 rupees. That is given in the question. Now again, the direct material cost, that will be 35 rupees as we calculated in the previous table. 35 rupees into 6,500. The direct labor is 6,500 into labor per unit, that is 40 rupees. Now for this 6,500 rupees, the number of batch will be 6,500 divided by 50. Because in usual order, the batch size is 50, that is given over here in the question. So 6,500 divided by 50 will give us the number of batches, and that multiplied by 500 rupees will give the direct manufacturing cost. So over here, the number of batches has been calculated, it will come out to 130. Now the fixed manufacturing cost will again levy on this same. Fixed manufacturing cost will remain constant. You can, I have written this to 2,75,000 and 1,75,000 under the usual order, or you can just combine it with the special order as well, because at last we are going to total out. At last we are going to make the total of total operating income we are going to calculate over here. So in the special order, 2,500 units are now calculating for the special order. That is 2,500 units. Again, the revenue will be 2,500 into 100 rupees. Why 100 rupees? Because the selling price of this special order is 100 rupees only. So it is given over here. The special order will be for 100 rupees per medal. So the revenue on from the special order will be 2,500 into 100. But the material cost will be again same as the previous one. That is 2,500 into 35 rupees. And the labor will be 2,500 into 40. And the direct manufacturing cost will be 2,500 units divided by 100. That is 25 batch size. Now 25 batch size into 500 rupees per batch size. That is 1,25,000. 12,500 by what? So the total cost for this special order will be 2 lakh rupees. The total cost for the usual order will be 10,25,000. So the total cost of the usual order plus special order, that is equals to the 9,000 units, that is the total manufacturing capacity of the firm, will come out to 10,25,000 plus 2 lakh, that is 12,02,500. And the total revenue will be 12,25,000. So the operating income will be revenue minus the total cost, that is 22,500. So this is the scenario when we take the special order. Now suppose we reject the special order completely. That is, we are not accepting the order of 2,500 units, but still the capacity of the company is 9,000 units only. So in this case, what you will do is you will only manufacture as per the usual order. you will not go ahead and go ahead with the special order. You will manufacture 9,000 units of usual order only. So in that case, the revenue will be 9,000 into 150 rupees per model. The direct material will be 9,000 into 35 rupees. The direct manufacturing cost will be 3,60,000. That is 9,000 into 40 rupees. And here the direct manufacturing cost will be 9,000 units. That is the batch size is the total unit is 9,000 divided by the batch size. So the batch size of this was 50 models per batch. So 9,000 divided by 50 multiplied by 500 rupees per batch. That comes out to 90,000. So now the fixed manufacturing cost and the fixed marketing cost again going to remain same irrespective of the number of units manufactured. So that is again 2,75,000 plus 1,75,000. So the total cost comes out to be 12,15,000. Now again, we will calculate the operating income, that is revenue 1,13,50,000 minus 12,15,000. That comes out to 1,35,000. So in the previous case, our total operating income was 22,500. Whereas if we don't accept the special order, the income is 1,35,000. So we will go ahead with, we will not take the special order and go ahead manufacturing the usual orders. That will be the answer to this question. Now the third case that is given to us, as in requirement one, number one, assume that the monthly capacity is 10,000 metal. Tanishq is concerned that if it accepts the special order, its existing customers will immediately demand a price discount of rupees 10 in the month in which special order is being filled. They will argue that Tanishq capacity costs are being spread over more units and that existing customers should get the benefit of this lower cost. Should Tanishq accept the special order under these conditions? So your calculation. So now what is happening over here is that in the first case, we accepted the special order with the capacity of 10,000 units. So now what the customers are arguing that for the usual order, the price per metal was 150 rupees, but now the price, the customers are demanding 10 rupees discount on a single metal and the price will be 140 rupees per metal for the usual order. So now what the company should do? Should the company take the special order or reject the special order? That is the case given to us. So now again, the first scenario that we are considering is that company rejects the special order. Company is not willing to take the special order. So for the 10,000 capacity of 10,000, the company will manufacture the usual order. So by manufacturing the usual order, the company will be able to manufacture 10,000 units. So multiplying 10,000 with the price of the metal, that is 150, we get 15 lakhs. Now calculating the direct material at 35 rupees per unit, direct labor at 40 rupees per unit, and the direct manufacturing cost, that is 10,000 divided by 50 into 500. So that comes out to be, again, 1 lakh rupees. And again, the fixed manufacturing cost remains the same, fixed marketing cost remains the same. So the total cost comes out to be 13 lakh and the operating income is 2 lakh. That is when the company doesn't accept the special order. So company does not provide any discount on their usual order. So the price will remain 150. Now, if company goes ahead and accepts the special order, so what will happen in that case is, so now here we calculated the income. The total income of the company, here we calculated the total operating income, that was 87,500. So I will make it simpler for you. 87,500 was the total income of the company. Now, what will be the reduction in revenue? Company needs to reduce 10 rupees per the usual order. So 10 rupees per usual order, that is 10 rupees will be deducted, and the number of units of the usual order were 7,500. So into 7,500. So 10 into 7,500. So that is 75,000 will be the reduction in revenue. So the total total reduction in revenue will be 75,000. So now the income of the company will stand out to be 12,500 rupees only, because here the price per medal was 150 rupees, and that is 10 rupees is deducted from each medal. So there will be decrease in revenue of 75,000, that is 7,500 units into 10 rupees reduction in revenue. So 75,000 will be the reduction in revenue. So previously the revenue was 87,500, and after the reduction in revenue, that is 75,000 rupees. Now the revenue profit remains 12,500 rupees only. So if the company takes special order, the revenue will be 12,500. But if the company rejects the special order, the revenue will be 2 lakh rupees. So the special orders would be rejected in this case. That is all with the first case.